Welcome back, everybody. It's another crispy, frosty start to a new year with Beaverworks Diecast Racing, Endy Igloo Proving Grounds, starting it off with another run down our new medium-ranged off-road track, the Pebble Path. Yeah, there it is. We got four trucks this time. Pickup trucks, old trucks, new trucks, military crossover trucks. We've got it all. It's going down the Pebble Path this week. All right. Essentially, the Pebble Path is the old service road that used to go around the outside of the main track, and we have converted it into an off-road course, a little bit lighter than our heavy rock stone road, but still a little bit more than main track. So, medium range. Vehicles.
Matchbox, 2015 Cadillac Escalade.
7 out of 12 from the 2021 Cadillac series. There has been four different versions, bringing to life a new category of vehicle in the luxury SUV so rich kids could not get dirty.
Hot Wheels, 1978 Dodge Lil Red Express.
10 out of 10 from the 2019 Hot Wheels truck series. There's been 13 versions of this guy since 2012, based on the 78-79 D-Series pickup truck that was red with stacks.
Hot Wheels Toyota Land Cruiser.
3 out of 10 from the 2021 Hot Wheels truck series. This is a new casting based on the FJ40 body style. The FJ40 had an epic production run from 1960 to 2001.
Matchbox Hummer H2 SUV.
6 out of 20 from the 2019 MBX Construction Series. There has been 30 versions and has been a staple in the Matchbox diet since 2003 with a retool in 2015.
Run one.
Starting off tonight is driver Cindy Sixpack in that Cadillac Escalade. Look at that thing, it's great. Looking down off the ramp and into the rough stuff off the top over top of the lip, and is coming down through all of the loose slop and down onto the logs over top of the line with a 10.01 time. That is fast. That's a benchmark to start the night off with right there, because that is going to be a tough time to beat. Look at that. Pretty smooth on the bottom half and into the trap at the end. Checking out the Igloo replay, how well this run went. Nice and smooth off the ramp. Didn't get too messed up in that first corner. Comes over top of the drop-off lip there into the big hill through the rough stuff. Was able to cut a half-decent line. Stayed off the edges. Got a little squirrely there coming onto the logs, but the logs was a breeze. A little bouncy, a little squirrely, but that Escalade took it all. No problem. Probably had a nice beverage in the inside there, enjoying the ride. There she is. 10.01 in the Escalade. First run. Nice.
Run two.
All right, we've got D-Man in the Dodge Little Red Express. Might be asking why this one's blue. Well, if you see a blue Little Red Express out there, that means somebody did body work on it, because they all came red. Anyways, down over top of the first lip, and he's coming down through the loose stuff, sliding through there nice over top of the logs. Real good. Out the bottom end with a 12.62. Got a little slowed up on the top half there, but still made it with the shiny side up, and that thing looks nice and shiny and nice. Great looking casting coming down from the front view. See him parking it nice and pretty in the stack at the end. All right, D-Man coming down off the ramp in the Igloo replay. Let's get this all in slow-mo. Watch that beauty of a casting get bounced around all over the place over top of the first lip. And this is where you get the good drop down through that little canyon, through all of the loose rough stuff there, and just enough barely to make it onto the logs, but he got it up there. That Dodge pulled it through. That old two-wheel drive with the stacks, the Little Red Express, beautiful little truck that they made, and over top of the line at the end, he made it. That thing was great. Classic pickup there. 12.62 for D-Man in the Dodge.
Run three.
First run in the Toyota, and it is Kowalski that we got taking the Land Cruiser down this run. Check it out. Down off the ramp is good. It's all over the place. That Land Cruiser is built for this kind of stuff. It is the medium range right off the factory floor over top of the logs, and they're tough as nails. 11.51 over the line. A little slow on the top half, but came out on the bottom. Great job there. Let's check out the replay. Thing looks nice and smooth and come right up and kisses the camera at the end there. Nice igloo replay going down the ramp. Slow-mo, you can see him. Just gets a little hung up at the start there and ends up pulling through, no problem. Gets over top of the lip, takes the big dive into the valley, gets into some slop, and that's where he lost some time, got sideways, but he was able to power through all of those big wheels there. This might be a good enough casting to switch over to the stone road. We'll give it a shot. We'll check it out. Over top of the line and right to the very end of the track there. Nice job there by Kowalski, 11.51 in the Clan Cruiser.
Run four.
All right, time for the Hummer H2 SUV to give it a shot with Rashadi R driving it down. The pedal path, let's see how he comes off the ramp, is good. Tries to crawl up the wall a little bit there, but that thing is wide. It is just so big and is coming down over top of the logs. Doing nice with it. Wait, no, he's on his lid. He flipped it. Oh my, he came over top of the line upside down, but still made it over the line with an 11.38. That does count, but still doesn't look any good when you do the old puppy dog belly rub over top of the line. Here he comes on the igloo replay. Let's see what happened there. Almost flips it, coming right off the ramp. Gets a little squirrely, has some difficulty getting out of that top corner, but still was able to make it. And gets to the lip, drops through the valley, gets into the thick stuff, and then crawls up on top of the logs there, and he starts getting the momentum. Rashadi's just giving her there, and then that was it. He just caught a bad edge, rode up the wall, and that rolled him over. Still was able to make it over the line with 11.38 in the Hummer. Nice. Great first round so far, and we have got Cadillac Escalade is in the lead with a 10.0 time. Cindy Sixpack there. The Little Red Express last place with a 12.62. Toyota Land Cruiser, 11.51. And second place so far is the Hummer H2 with Rashadi R driving that sucker. Oh, yeah. Here's your chance, folks. We need you to grab that like button. That helps the algorithm. It helps us out a lot. You can even grab the notification bell. That helps a lot, too. Subscribing, leaving us a little comment, as always, is always great. And there's even a super thanks option now. New way to help out content creators.
Run five.
All right, second run for the Cadillac Escalade. Cindy Sixpack still got the time to beat. Here goes the second run. Tries to crawl up the wall a little bit there, having a little bit of problems in that first corner, but still getting good speed down through the leaf stuff. Over top of the logs, doing good. Flying off the bottom half and comes out with an 11.38 time. Still not as fast as the last time, but again, wanted to make this one look good from the top up. Look at that view. Right down to the camera face. Good stuff down the igloo replay. Check it out in slow-mo, that run. You can see not quite getting the line she wanted on that top corner. Got a little bit of a rough start there. Gets to the drop-off flip there into the valley. Down through the loose stuff, no problem. Starts catching up. Gets some speed. Momentum starts catching through there. Up on top of the logs. Make it a great run out the bottom and over top of the finish line. Nice job driving there. Cindy Sixpack in that Matchbox Cadillac Escalade pulling an 11.38 on the second run.
Run six.
All right, here we go. Second run for D-Man in the Little Red Express. This is a classic pickup. Used to love seeing these things driving around. Very rare now, but when you do see them, it's a treat. Checking it out down the main line and down over top of the logs. Flying good. Comes through with a 12.10 time. That's an improvement from his last time there. Still looks awesome sitting down there. That flatbed with the step side and the stacks. All right. Down from the bottom camera into the stuff at the bottom. Off the ramp here in the igloo replay. D-Man holding that thing together. Classic pickup truck. Got a classic dude driving it. Over through the first corner. Did great. Over top of the lip. Coming down through all the loose stuff. See that Dodge just powering through there. Two-wheel drive. Still making it through. No problem. Lots of power in those things. They came with a 360 big block. great truck engine, great looking stacks, down over top of the line. All right. D-Man pulling that classic Little Red Express through with a 12.10 time.
Run seven.
Second run for the Toyota Land Cruiser, Kowalski taking her down. Down the ramp he goes. That's how we start him off here on the pedal path. Give him a little boost to help him down that first little stretch around the corner. He's making it through the loose stuff over top of the logs and flying. Good, great time with a 10.34. Big improvement over the last time. And still taking it right to the camera right at the very end. Nice job there. All right, checking out the Igloo replay, going slow-mo down on this run. Give you all the gory details coming out of that first corner. You got a little slow down there. That's a tricky corner to maneuver. He gets over top of that first lip. That's great, because then he goes down through the valley, gets lots of momentum through all of that loose stuff and slop, and then gets on top of the logs with a big wheelie there. Almost goes over, but is able to hold on to it, gets down over top of the line and sliding through the loose trap at the end. Great run there by Kowalski, 10.34 in that Toyota Land Cruiser.
Run eight.
All right, here we go. Last run of the day, second run for the Hummer. Rashadi R taking her down. H2 is down off the ramp and coming through the first corner, making it through a little bit better that time. Coming through the deep stuff, back and forth, and over top of the logs, manages to stay shiny sight up this time, comes over the line with a 10.40. Good time there. Really solid on that run. Nice and straight on the bottom half and slows it down before he gets into the camera. Still, here we go with the Igloo replay slow-mo. See, getting through that top corner much easier this time. Still slows him down a little bit, gets to that lip, and then he is down the big stretch through the valley and then gets through all of the deep stuff coming onto the logs, then just guns it. Just like last time, but this time tips it on the wheels. Gets a little end-o-ish there, but still, he is through. He is at the end. Great time for that Hummer, 10.40 on the second run. Rashadi R taking her down through there, and that is wrapping it up for tonight, folks. It looks like it's going to be the 2015 Cadillac Escalade with a 10.0 run on its first run. She is taking that one. The Dodge had two 12s. Good improvement on the Toyota. He went from 11 to a 10. Same with the Hummer, went from a 11.38 to a 10.40, but that was still not quite enough to catch up the Cindy six-pack in the Cadillac Escalade. That matchbox with the blacked out wheels and the white finish, got all the chrome on the inside of it there. That's a great looking casting they came off with. Got lots of nice little painted stuff all over it, taillights, and got all the details. Great looking casting there, and great performance coming down the pebble path from all of the drivers this week. We had some old versus new, some Matchbox versus Hot Wheels. Oh yeah, great stuff. All right, that's gonna wrap it up again this week, folks. Make sure you get over and check out our TikTok page and our Instagram. That's out there too. Just look up Beaver Works on either one of them. And big track shout out to all of you good folks who keep on watching our stuff. We love doing this and keep on doing it just for you. All right. From Beaverworks Diecast Racing, we will see you next time.